In this video presentation, I'm going to give an overview of the ClickToGo remote. The ClickToGo remote offers an alternative way to drive in a chair using a single switch or multiple switches. It is typically used where an individual will find it hard to use a standard joystick on a chair. It can be connected to any chair that has DX controls. This is typically found on quite a number of chairs. As well as controlling the chair itself, it can control any onboard chair functions, such as the lights or seat control, or an external device connected. And in this case, I have the gear prop connected. Other devices could be a user's communication aid or something like that there. So, pressing the switch, you can see on the panel I have an indication of the battery level. There's also an arrangement of 8 LEDs in circular pattern, which indicates the 8 possible drive directions. There's also a 7-7 display, which indicates the drive profile, which can be changed. And there's also an LED for the user to power on and off the chair, to go to external control, and to go to other seat functions or chair functions, such as the lights or seat control. So at the moment, it's scanning as an automatic scan. So the LEDs are scanned once at a time. So just press that again so you can see some movement of the chair. At the moment, the LEDs are scanning the forward direction. The LEDs are scanning most, just to make the movement a bit more efficient. Other scanning options or operating modes would be a single switch short click, which basically is a short click to advance the scan, and a long click then to select the scan. Other options are two switch step scan, where the user uses two switches, and one switch again advances the scan and the other switch selects the scan. There's also a three switch scan method, and this is typically used with a headrest, where there will be three switches combined in the headrest, one to go left, one to go right, and the other is one at the back would be to go forward and backwards, where a short click kind of toggles the direction of forward and back. And then there's also a five switch, where you can use a digital joystick, or you could use a five switch array. So just selecting some of the other chair functions. I've got to select this one here, which allows me to either control the lights or the chair actuators. So here I can either extend or retract one of the chair actuators. These first two control one actuator, the next two control the others. Just to bring that back again. To exit then from the chair actuators, I have to wait until it comes here again, and now I'm back into drive. So to then use, let's say, an external device, so I have this gear prop connected up and programmed to control my CD player. So I've selected external control. So now any switch presses of my switch are routed directly to the gear prog. So as if it was connected directly to the gear prog. So pressing the switch starts the scan here on the gear prog. So So it goes through the options, select this track number 5. And then I can stop that there. And a long switch hold while in external access will exit external access. So it takes about 3 seconds. So other options for the ClickToGo are the heading lock. And this is a device which allows basically to minimize veering while driving in a straight line. Fine tuning of the device is done using a programming switch underneath the ClickToGo. And here the therapist or technician can actually select how many switches are being set up on the ClickToGo, the type of drive pattern, the way it scans, or maybe to include or exclude some of the other options like the on-off or the external access or the seat functions. So they are the main functions of the ClickToGo.